However, our today's topic is presentation skills. I have got many messages that we are not able to present ourselves. Guys, we are living in a 21st century and presentation skills will always play a key role. We many a time have to convey our thoughts to the other person. Even in the day-to-day activities, we various times have to convey our thoughts. So how to improve it? So guys, here we welcome you to our channel, and I, the member of team AAP IAS, am here to discuss various things about presentation skills. So today's topic is learn to convey your thoughts. In day-to-day life, we have to convey our feelings, thought to the other person. So how to do it perfectly and rightly? So here I am with 5 to 6 measures which you have to take, which will help you to improve it. So guys, moving toward first measure, it is self-clarity. Guys, you must be knowing about concept Chinese whisper. What is Chinese whisper? It is nearly a game in which if a person conveys something to the other person, then the second person would take it somewhat wrong, and if when he conveys to the third person, the meaning would change. For example, if I convey to a person that my father gifted me a car, so that other person would convey the same sentence to the third person and this would go on. But when the last person would hear the sentence, he won't hear this like his father gifted him a car. He would realize it, he would get it like his father celebrated the birthday of his car or something like that. So the meaning of the sentence changes. Why is it too? This is because of two things. First, the person who is telling the other person is not able to communicate his thoughts properly. And second, the person who is listening is not able to catch up the thoughts rightly. So our first point is self-clarity. If you are not clear about a topic you want to convey, then you can't convey it. This is the line by many of the experts in the field. So first of all, you have to be 150% correct, 150% assured about the information. How 150%? So guys, first of all, you have to be extremely careful and perfect with the information you are having. But you also have to catch and get up with the information related to that topics, like buts, ifs and buts, do's and don'ts, etc. So you have to be extremely correct and knowledgeable about the topic you are explaining to someone else. Guys, our second topic is don't argue but discuss. Guys, we various times see people fighting about silly things. This is because they are not discussing the things, they are arguing. There is a famous sentence, discussing would lead you to a result, but arguing would lead you to nothing. So guys, we have to discuss, not argue. What is the difference? The difference between discussing and arguing is, if you are just fighting for your correctness with other person, then that's arguing. For example, if I am communicating to someone other and I am not agreeing with his views, but then also I am like, yeah, okay, you might be correct, you might be wrong, but I do not agree with you. You may tell the reasons why you agree. So this is a healthy discussion. We are not hurting each other, we are not fighting. But if I say, like we bolte na muh pe bol diya ki no, your thoughts are wrong, they are useless, etc. So here argument will start. You don't have to argue. The best communicator is a person who agrees with other. सबसे पहले agree कर जाओ, जो भी सामने वाला बंदा जो भी बात बोल रहा है उससे agree करो कि हाँ तो सही है. But मैं कुछ चीज़ों से सहमत नहीं हूँ, I am not agreeing with some of the things. So can you convey me about that some things? So here the person with whom you are communicating would also take interest in you. And once this interest bonding gets up, then definitely you would be able to reach to a conclusion with a discussion. Arguing will never let you to a conclusion. So guys, here our third point is, be polite. Politeness is the best way to communicate. We all love to listen to polite persons. Guys, nowadays on news channels we see people fighting with each other without any reasons. They are just fighting with some other parties, people or etc. So this is like they are not polite with the discussion. So if you are polite, then the interest of your voice in the ears of the listener would get up. The listener would take interest in your thoughts, and once anyone is getting interest in your thoughts, then that proves that your thoughts are effective. Be polite. How you can be polite? This might be the question. Guys, first of all, as I earlier also said, stop disagreeing to the people. You must say them, you may be correct, you may be wrong, but I don't agree. So this is the right way to communicate. First of all, stop segregating people as right or wrong. Start segregating them as like-minded and different-minded. And when you segregate them as different-minded, then make sure that this different minded are also your friends. So be polite, be humble. Humbleness is the key to success. The person who is successful is always humble. You won't see any superstar or something be arrogant. So arrogancy is what you have to ignore. So guys, moving to our next point, it is language. Yeah guys, your language should be extremely attractive. I'm not saying use hard words or very stringent words, but guys, you can at least use some different words that would make your language very attractive. Instead of using words like motivation, hard work, use the words like perseverance, key to perseverance, etc. This will make your language attractive. Use phrases, use idioms, even quotes. Nowadays quotes are playing great role. So like, yeah, if you would follow this pattern, then definitely you would be able to communicate your views properly. So moving towards last point, be confident, not egoistic. What is the difference between confidence and ego? Listen carefully. What is the difference between confidence and ego? Confidence is saying that I am correct and only I am correct. Overconfidence or ego is saying that only I can do this thing in the world. Yeah, saying that I am able to do this is confidence, but thinking that only I can, that word only can ruin your life. For example, if I am saying here I am able to communicate my views, that's confidence. But if I would say no one in the world can do it better than me, then it's overconfidence or ego. So ego kills. Yeah guys, ego kills your communication, your process of communication, your technique to communicate, each and everything. So guys, please make sure you are never egoistic, as definitely ego is going to kill you. So guys, here I would like to say you that yeah, I am going to discuss these topics with you in the further videos. So if you are liking this content, do subscribe our channel AAP IAS, click the red button in the below, and do press the bell icon also for more updates. Yeah guys, it takes a lot of effort to make such videos, so please guys, make sure you like if you really like the video, or you may dislike, no issues. So guys, here we would end this video, and thank you for watching. Do subscribe, share and like. Thank you guys.